This game is for third place in the 35th annual E.C.A.C. Holiday Festival. Here are the starting lineups. For the Cavaliers of the University of Virginia, at forward, number 42, Andrew Kennedy. For the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers University, at forward, number 32, Lee Perry. At forward for Virginia, number 22, Tom Sheehy. At forward for Rutgers, number 00, Eric Riggins. At center for the Cavaliers, number 52, John Dislin. For the Scarlet Knights at center, number 50, Mark Peterson. At the guards for Virginia, number 10, John Johnson. At guard for Rutgers, number 10, Rick Dattica. And at guard for the Cavaliers, number 21, Mel Kennedy. And for the Scarlet Knights, number 22, Miles Dixon. The coach of the Scarlet Knights, Craig Littlepage. And the coach of the Cavaliers, Terry Holland. The officials, Tom Lutz.
Rutgers and Virginia, third place game from the Garden. Here's a look at the matchups for tonight's third place game.
It's going to go hungry, pal.
Sheehy and Riggins ought to be a good one. I expect Virginia to do some zoning, though. I expect them to press and zone and try to do collectively against Riggins inside what Georgia Tech was trying to do man for man, and with very little success.
This is an interesting game because Craig Littlepage was the assistant coach at Virginia to Terry Holland for 6 years. They've met once before when Littlepage was at 10, and Virginia was successful, although Ted had rattled off 22 consecutive points in the early going of the first half and then bowed out. There's Craig Littlepage, second year head coach of the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers.
He was also an assistant to Rolly Massimino at Villanova, and his college coaches were Dick Carter and Chuck Daly, so his background in terms of exposure is excellent.
Tom Lopes, Tom Corbin, Dick Lynch, officials for this ballgame. Rutgers in the home white with the red trim. Virginia in the visiting orange with the blue trim, and this opening tip is controlled by Virginia. Cavaliers coming in 5-2. Lost to St. John's in the opening round of the ECAC. Rutgers 2-6. They lost to Georgia Tech by 18 on Saturday. Mel Kennedy with the ball comes off the solid effort in the opening game. Kennedy led the way with 18 points for the Cavaliers. Johnson to Mel Kennedy, firing for three. Rebound, knocked out of bounds, last touch by Tom Sheehy, and it will be Rutgers' ball.
Rutgers packing it in with his own. The Cavaliers going man for man on the miss.
Eric Riggins, 26 points, led the Scarlet Knights in scoring. Rich Dattica swings it out to Miles Dixon. And the rebound is controlled underneath by John Dislin. Here's John Johnson, where he's best in transition. Andrew Kennedy backs it out to Johnson. Sheehy for three. Two in and out three-point attempts by Virginia. Both pretty good shots, Bucky. Just wouldn't go down.
This is a good Virginia ball club. If you recall, they led St. John's by three at the half and succumbed to a superb St. John's effort. Some long spurts accompanied with a good trapping defense and a deep bench. St. John's bench played awfully well on Saturday, much more so than the three so-called franchise players.
Eric Riggins air ball, but the rebound is pulled down by Peterson. Loose underneath, Rutgers will keep possession. So still no score. And we're a minute and 22 seconds into the game.
A pensive Craig Littlepage trying to break a six-game losing streak.
Riggins, got it. 2-0 Rutgers.
Well, as we knew, he's so erratic. Getting off to a good start is very crucial. Rutgers in a soft 2-2-1 three-quarter press. No problem for Johnson.
Mel Kennedy back to Johnson. Johnson playing before the home crowd. A native New Yorker, Tarleton High School in the Bronx. He fires from the outside and he hits. Two-point shot by John Johnson, who is averaging on the season 8 points per game.
He was 2 for 6 on Saturday afternoon, only 6 points, but those 12 assists gave Lou Carnesecca lots to be concerned about.
He had 6 turnovers in that game also.
2-to-1 ratio for a guy as active as he was against pretty good St. John's defense. That's a good afternoon's work.
Riggins shot rebounded by Andrew Kennedy. Here's John Johnson running the show. Last year he came off the bench and filled in for Tom Callaway, who's been out this year with an injury.
He still played more minutes than any other Virginia player off the bench.
Mel Kennedy shot it short. Rich Gattaca has the rebound. Rutgers on a fast break. Gattaca dishes to Riggins, lays it in. Pretty feed.
Gattaca, who was very impressive on Saturday, off to a good start in this one.
I thought so. Gattaca made 4 3-pointers in that game. That was his only field goals in the contest. He finished with 12 points. Dixon on the steal. Miles goes coast to coast, but a little bit too much showtime and steps his ball.
Mark Jackson pulled one of those too on Saturday yeah. afternoon, trying to put a little mustard on it. Why coaches gray? Soft pressure still. Big men up front. Riggins on the front of that press. This 6'8 could cause some problems.
Sheehy with the ball for Virginia. Mel Kennedy and Johnson playing catch on the perimeter. Sheehy for 3. Off the mark. Virginia using the 3-point attempt so far. 0 for 3 in that department. 2-2, 16-40, first half of play. Johnson penetrates. Mel Kennedy. Riggins has the rebound and he is hacked. So a little thin guy got in there and was pushed around a bit.
Yeah, guys who wear double zero, they're impervious to those kinds of external problems.
Don't understand what you have against guys with double zero.
You got to be different to wear double zero, that's all.
Here's Miles Dixon penetrating and fishing off. And going up strong and laying it in is Mark Peterson, who had only 2 points against Virginia.
Nice feed by Dixon. He was under control that time. St. Anthony's guard has at times had a little too much speed.
What number did you wear anyway?
10.
10, I wore 11.
That was 1-0.
Your career was a little more pronounced than mine. 16 minutes to go, and Rutgers off to the quick start, leading 6-2. Sheehy on the baseline. Virginia is ice cold, and the rebound to Perry. Lee Perry ahead to Miles Dixon. Gattaca, side jump. Melvin Kennedy is there to sweep the boards. Here's John Johnson, 3-on-3. He penetrates. Tipped up and in by Sheehy.
Virginia's wanting to press, but they haven't been able to score to set it up.
Rutgers 6-4. Buck, you didn't even have to see the number because the way Sheehy plays, you know he's going to get that kind of rebound.
Why?
Because he's always around the basket. He's like an overachiever player. Hard worker, not the purest jump shooter, but he gets his points around the basket.
Okay.
Riggins, he hits. Next question.
Riggins, inside and out, off to a big start.
Rutgers 8, Virginia 4, just underway. 14:55, first half of play from the Garden in the third place game of the E.C.A.C. Holiday Festival.
Waiting on you with a smile. More. Coast to coast, Skinny's got your style. More. Of the fit you want today.
More is why we often say Kinney. We're the great American shoe store. Because America's shoe store has more. Kinney, we're the great American shoe store. Because America's shoe store has more.
Are you anything like my brother Jack? He figured the only way to get into a serious road car was to go empty his bank account and buy something from the Black Forest. Well, I talked him into driving a Mazda 626. Now he's going around telling everyone he knows about refinements, like the better aerodynamics, the new fuel injection, and the great performance. But the way I figured, I saved old Jack about $7,000. You think I'll ever see any of it?
No way.
That's what I thought.
Gattaca, trying to go coast to coast. Got that dribble under control, little shovel pass, and here comes Riggins at 6'8", filling the lane beautifully. Double zero down in the corner. Virginia defense laying back, concerned about Riggins' inside play, gets a double dose. Look at the shooting. Rutgers 44%, Virginia only 25, 2 for 8, and at least three of those are from three-point range.
And steps called on Andrew Kennedy. Andrew Kennedy, the kind of ball player that gets the job done very quietly. He had 14.7 for 11 shooting in the first round of the Holiday Festival. Terry Holland said, I couldn't believe it when I picked up the final stat sheet and saw he had 14. Rutgers with a four-point lead. Gattaca, Dixon, Peterson, and the rebound controlled by Sheehy. Virginia Cavaliers have lost to Temple and St. John's. They have won five, including a win at Arkansas. Last game before they go into ACC country. They'll open up with Duke on January 3rd. John Johnson penetrates. Sheehy dumps it inside to Kennedy. Knocked away by Gattaca. He got called for a foul.
Rutgers covering down very well. Virginia really not stressing that inside game. Even Sheehy shooting from outside.
You know, Bucky, it seems as we look at Morgan coming into the game that you don't get called for the reach and foul when you're hitting with your palm facing upwards, and when you hit down on the ball, that's when you get called for the reach.
Yeah, and there's another thing to keep in mind when you're reaching, especially on a dribbler. You reach as the ball is leaving his hand on the way down because it doubles your time when it's free to go down and back. Too many players start when the ball is on the floor, and you only have half as much time when it's up for grabs.
Here's Morgan in the game. Richard Morgan, a 6'3 sophomore from Salem, Virginia. Good outside shooter, although he was only 2 for 11 against St. John's.
He just killed him. Worse than that, he turned the ball over, just did not play well at all. He had been starting.
Mel Kennedy's following the miss by Morgan. He has his first bucket. Virginia cuts the lead to 8-6.
Boy, Dixon went right through that trap. Sheehy on the front's got his work cut out for him if he's going to contain Dixon.
Eric Riggins.
Very confident early.
8 for Riggins. Four times this year he's been over 20. Scarlet Knights 10, Virginia 6. And a turnover as Johnson threw that one well over the head of Sheehy. Here's Tim Martin, who did not play against St. John's. He is a 6'11 sophomore from Ridgeway, Virginia. He replaces Dislett in the middle. If there's a problem that Virginia has, it is getting a solid post player.
That's the result of Olin Polonais, New York area player who did not play his senior year and would have been the dominating center in the Atlantic Coast Conference.
Peterson doing a nice job off the boards, but the rebound comes down to Richard Morgan. Melvin Kennedy, Johnson, he fires. Rebound controlled by the big man, Peterson. Here's Dixon in transition, penetrates, dishes off to Gattaca, who loses the ball, and it will be Virginia basketball.
The numbers were even. You might have said, well, Rutgers should have held that ball up. I don't think so. They play 3-on-3. It's a pretty good offensive opportunity down there. They just didn't hold on to it. Let's see how they solve this press. 2-2-1, it's not terribly forceful. Perry and Riggins on the front of it.
And Dixon gets the steal, but Melvin Kennedy recovers. Virginia having all sorts of problems. Morgan out of control, jumps on the table, and it is a turnover.
You were almost wearing number 11 on your forehead, Bruce Beck.
I was grabbing the sodas.
That's why I have plastic over my idiot card here.
Protecting the magic markers of the scorecard.
not supposed to be a contact sport for an announcer.
Riggins fires and hits, and Eric Riggins has 10 points in the ball game, 5 for 5 from the field.
Terry Holland has to be thinking about a little boxing one, something to cool Mr. Riggins off.
See, he called for traveling on the baseline, checking Riggins. He is 5 for 7 from the field. But Rutgers has doubled the output of Virginia, and the Scarlet Knights lead by a score of 12-6 inside of 12 minutes to play in the first half.
An automobile accident takes just a moment. The suffering can last a lifetime. If you or a loved one are injured in an accident, seek legal advice. It won't cost you anything to discuss your case, and a lawyer will give you the guidance and support you need in your time of crisis. Remember, accidents don't just happen. People cause them. See a lawyer.
This message has been brought to you by Lieberman and Ryan, attorneys at law.
Most new car dealers doing commercials tell you how great their sales department is. Well, at Gateway Olds, we are one of New Jersey's largest dealers in sales, but we're also something else, a top quality service dealer. Last year, Gateway Olds had the biggest increase in customer satisfaction of any GM dealer in the entire country. My staff and I know the value of how to handle one of these to fix your car right. So shop around and compare, and see how to really save in sales and service at Gateway Oldsmobile, Route 22 in Bound Brook.
The Rangers take on the Islanders. What a way to spend New Year's Eve with us on Madison Square Garden Network. That's Wednesday evening. The rivalry continues. It begins with game night right here on Madison Square Garden Network at 7 p.m. Make your plans for New Year's Eve and spend the early part with us on MSG Network. Rutgers leads Virginia by 6, and here's Riggins racing to the front court. Rebound, Morgan.
Team playing very well right now, playing for third place before basically an empty arena. Very difficult. You're coming off a loss. Nobody's really into it. I expect these teams to heat up, although Rutgers playing the better of the two.
Melvin Kennedy looks inside, hands out to Johnson. Here's Morgan. He puts that ball up so high, and on the whistle, Eric Riggins is called for pushing off underneath.
I'm mystified by Morgan's release. Technically, it's so good, the hard arc, the full extension, and the follow-through, but he really doesn't have much backspin, which you normally see with that kind of a shooting stroke.
Well, what Terry Holland was worried about has happened thus far. He said he was concerned about a letdown. As finally, Virginia Morgan connects. He said psychologically, after coming off the intense game against St. John's, he was worried that his club was thinking ahead to the ACC season.
I think that's one of the reasons they're trying to press, but Sheehy's having a great deal of trouble on the front of that press with Dixon and Dattica. Too quick for him.
Sheehy to Morgan. Now Morgan's in transition for the Cavaliers. Takes the baseline, foul call to John Dattica.
Boy, Morgan just took it right down, put great pressure. It appeared that he fully intended to do malice down there. It was like 1-on-3, but no one really punched his ticket.
Andrew Kennedy back in. Melvin Kennedy gets a breather. Dattica in charge of the second personal. Rutgers with 3 team fouls. Virginia with 1. 10:35, first half of play. Rutgers 12, Virginia 8. Sheehy outside to John Johnson. Morgan looks inside, goes to Sheehy. Loves to play in the corner, does Sheehy? Turnaround by Kennedy, way off the mark, and here's Miles Dixon. And it goes to number 14, Steve Brown, in the game for the first time for Rutgers. Also in for the Scarlet Knights, Steve Watson, a freshman from Franklinville, New York. Lee Burry. Brown, nice fake. Rebound to Morgan. And Morgan's trying to get things going for the Cavaliers. He pulls, he hits.
He's some athlete coming off that bench. He has been a starter, did not start against St. John's because Mel Kennedy playing at home. In fact, it was Morgan's idea to start him at home. I'm sure the Virginia coaching staff is having some second thoughts about breaking up a starting lineup that was doing very well, especially when Morgan did not play well coming off the bench.
Steve Watson to Miles Dixon, Scarlet Knights by a bucket. Brown, long cross court feed to Watson. 14 seconds on the shot clock. Dixon penetrates. Rebound Sheehy, there he is again.
Kind of reminds you of the Busher in there, the way he's banging, slamming, throwing his body in there on the glass.
Foul call as John Johnson penetrated. And it's on number 14.
Some people rebound effortlessly, play the game effortlessly. He's one of those people that you know is just double clutching and trucking. He's out there working the entire time. Hobson of North Carolina, a similar player, both heralded high school players whose college careers have just not been very glowing in terms of stats.
Morgan pops it out to Andrew Kennedy. What about that thrust of St. John's? Doesn't look like he's working, does it?
Only when his incisors bite into his lower lip. Yeah, that guy, he plays like he hasn't been fed recently.
Steve Brown with it for Rutgers. 8:42 to go, low scoring first half. Rutgers 12, Virginia 10. Rutgers won their first two over Ryder and Lafayette. They've lost their last six. Duquesne, St. Bonaventure, Seton Hall, Princeton, West Virginia, Georgia Tech. Scarlet Knights turn it over. That's one of the reasons they've lost six in a row. Johnson with some clever moves. And Rutgers getting in foul trouble. That is team foul number five.
Virginia went man for man against Rutgers when Riggins was not in there. Let's see if they adjust their defense. Riggins really made shambles of the inside of Georgia Tech's man-to-man defense on Saturday afternoon.
Lance Blanks in the game. Number 32 for Virginia. Back in for Rutgers. And Riggins back in for the Scarlet Knights. So Peterson, Riggins, and Watson up front for Rutgers with Miles Dixon and Steve Brown in the backcourt. Sheehy to Morgan. Lance Blanks. Morgan fires. Just inside the three-point line. Virginia getting the offensive board.
They're packed in. Rutgers in that 2-3 zone, and when they're forcing that outside shot, the rebound is coming out further.
Riggins almost out of steal.
Starts to score early. He's assertive on all phases of the game.
So it's been a quiet first half of play. Neither club playing particularly well, but Rutgers has the two-point advantage. We'll be right back.
I'm Jimmy Connors, and it's about time you met my partner, my financial side.
All successful people and companies have a financial side.
Let's go, partner.
But to really be a winning team, you might need some help.
We need some help.
You need Bain Weber behind you for financial expertise, sound advice. We believe the quality of life just might depend on the quality of your financial services.
Thank you, Bain Weber. You're awfully stiff. You've got to loosen up a little bit.
At Aqueduct, smart New Yorkers take home over $2 million every day.
For $2, you can bet all six races?
It's the pick six. And what do you see the jackpot?
Just talent.
Where's the Big A been all our lives?
Right here.
Make money today. Go to the Big A. Post time, 12:30 p.m.
Welcome back to Madison Square Garden. I'm Bruce Beck, along with Bucky Waters. Dave Sims will be joining us between games to take your phone calls, anything you'd like to talk about in college hoops. As we mentioned early on, this is an interesting contest because it pits the coach against the assistant coach who used to work for him. Craig Littlepage was the assistant. And Terry Holland was the head coach at Virginia.
Littlepage is not thinking short term. When he fired Lloyd Moore, the huge center who just wouldn't conform to training rules and basically ate himself right out of college basketball, he showed everyone he wasn't sacrificing anything for short-term wins. He was going to build it right.
Andrew Kennedy has his first bucket, and we're tied at 12. Now here's a steal by Blanks. Three on one. Dumps it to Morgan. Beautiful feed. Six for Morgan. Riggin. He's provided the spark, and Virginia leads by two. Rutgers with a two-on-one. Riggins pushed, and he lays it in anyway. 12 for Riggins.
That wasn't a very hard shot until he was shoved, and then it was very difficult. Sheehy is just, he cannot put a double team on down there because of the quickness of the Rutgers guards. By the time he gets ready to set the trap, they're gone.
Blanks inside to Tim Martin. He turns, and he hits the 6'11 sophomore from Ridgeway, Virginia, averaging only 2.5 per game. That's his first bucket, and the Cavaliers lead by two.
Terry Holland coming early with Martin, trying to give him some playing time. Didn't show at all against St. John's on Saturday.
Brown for three. Got it. Steve Brown with his first bucket. He's a senior from the Corriston High School in Trent, New Jersey.
Co-captain. Good leader. Good defensive player. Good passer.
He was a starter a year ago. Was the only Rutgers player to start all 29 games. But this year, with Dixon developing, he's coming off the bench. In traffic, Kennedy. That's the way he gets his points. Quietly, workmanlike on the inside. Cavaliers by one. Rutgers breaks the press.
The front of that press, though, are not the people you want going to the basket with it.
Dixon. Off it goes to Perry, and he puts it in. So Lee Perry, who had no points in his last game, had 17 the game before against West Virginia, has his first bucket.
It's like he and Riggins are seesawing on the yo-yo performance offensively.
Well, believe it or not, Perry at 17 against West Virginia, he hadn't scored a point all year until that game. Virginia trails by one. Sheehy takes the baseline, puts it up, and in. 1 point, Virginia lead. Rutgers passing through the press.
Yeah, but it's no problem because Watson and Perry at the other end are not going to go down and make a play 2-on-1. So basically, Virginia's able to press without fear of them going to the basket.
So it's one thing if you're breaking the press, but another if you're not doing anything by breaking it.
Well, again, though, with those, with the big people down there, you know, in the second wave of the press, it's very difficult. You don't want them going down there trying to make guard plays.
Long bomb off the mark by Brown. Here come the Cavaliers. Blanks pushes it up court. Mel Kennedy back in the game. Mel outside to Blanks. Here's Morgan. Side jump. Got it. Morgan is warming up, and you can see him. He wants the ball. 8 for Morgan. 3-point Virginia lead. Rutgers led 12-6. Virginia scored 8 straight. Now the Cavaliers lead by 3. And a turnover on Rutgers, number 5.
Well, Miles Dixon trying to penetrate against that flat 1-2-2 zone. Really not much of a place to go. If he can get in there, get a couple dribbles in, pull two men to him and give it up, fine, but pretty tough to go all the way from out there.
Gattaca for Brown for Rutgers.
Not much variation in the Rutgers defense, just basically packing it in, trying to force the Cavaliers to fire from outside.
Bill Bates in the game for the first time for Virginia. Mel Kennedy, offensive board. Rebound, Andrew Kennedy, there he is again, feasting on the offensive glass, and Craig Littlefade wants to talk about it. Virginia leading by 5 at the 3:48 mark of half number one.
Uncle Sam is giving you the best reason to apply now for home equity ready credit. A rare tax deduction. Call Amboy Madison National Bank, 1-800-AMB-MTGS.
TKR Advertising. It can work for you.
The doctors at the Mattawan Aberdeen Chiropractic Center have been bringing pain relief to central New Jersey patients for years. You see, the spine is the main support of the body. Any misalignment can cause pain in any area of the body. The center can provide safe, natural relief of back pain and tension, and even related ailments such as pains in the legs, the arms, or the neck. They are equipped with the very latest technology and competent, experienced professionals. The Mattawan Aberdeen Chiropractic Center. Call for your consultation today.
Virginia working down inside. Sheehy down inside to Andrew Kennedy. Good power move, Kennedy. 7-for-11 against St. John's on Saturday. I wouldn't call him sneaky, but as you say, he gets him quiet. Actually, the Kennedys collectively, Mel and Andrew, were 14-for-21 from the floor against the Red Men, and it wasn't enough.
Virginia by 5. Biggest lead of the first half for the Cavaliers. Virginia killing Rutgers on the board, 17-9. 6 offensive rebounds for the Cavaliers. Virginia on an 18-7 run after being behind by 6 early. Here's Morgan, who seems to like our location here in the court, but he's hustling. That's the big thing.
Yes, he is.
You know, he struggled the other day, and the best thing to do if you're struggling is just to work hard. It'll come around.
Well, he did. He did hustle the other day too. It looked like a terminal case of garden jitters. Riggins called for pushing off, I believe. Good pressure man for man in there on a half-court basis by Virginia. Making all of the passing lanes contested.
For Rutgers, Emory Ward reports, replacing Eric Riggins.
Number 12 up for the Scarlet Knights.
Derek Sims in the game for Virginia. Here's Andrew Kennedy. Yes, and a foul. So Kennedy now with 8 points, and Virginia's lead is 26-19.
Andrew Kennedy, superb control here. Watch, stops. He's wearing 3 white jerseys, but he gets under control, finds a little daylight, powers up and in. That's good experience. That's a city player. 6'7" senior. Had 30 versus Southern Illinois. The last player to score 30 for the Wahoos of Virginia was Ralph Sampson.
9 points for Kennedy. Virginia 27, Rutgers 19. 9 in a row for the Cavaliers.
Much of it since they switched the tough man for man defense.
Miles Dixon hands off to Watson. Perry with the fall away. And it will be Virginia basketball.
That one was off of Rambo. He was in the middle of the fracas there, as usual.
Virginia by 8. This is number 20, Derek Sims. He is a junior from Alexandria, Virginia. And there's Rambo taking the ball away. Emory Ward. Danica dumps it off. Loose ball picked off by Sims. Here comes John Johnson. Rebound, Ward. And an offensive foul is called on Ward for pushing off.
A very strange play. It's like he forgot all about throwing an outlet pass. He wanted to make a couple of folks pay for grabbing them.
That's his first personal foul.
First foul on Ward, 17th foul on Rutgers. Virginia has committed only 1 team foul.
Looked like he was trying to use his elbow as a tongue depressor there.
Still Virginia ball, Bucky Wino free throw there. Player control foul?
Yeah. Yeah, he very definitely had it tucked under one arm and was trying to find a lip to split with his elbow.
Coming up on 2 minutes in this first half, this is the third place game between Virginia and Rutgers. Mel Kennedy off to John Johnson. 20 seconds of the shot clock. Sims pulls up. And again, Ward was way over the top of Batts. Now we have a foul call.
Knights not happy with that call. Personal number two on Emery Ward. And they came quickly. Now it's 1-1. Virginia will be shooting here with a minute 44 to go in the half, and the Cavaliers leading by 8. Well, you know why they call him Rambo? Because of his aggressive nature.
I was reading in the guide that he's a business major. He keeps playing with those fouls that way. They'll call him the Merchant of Menace. He is an accident waiting to happen.
Bats at the line, 1-1. Mel Kennedy with the offensive board, and he is fouled from behind by Perry. So pushing and shoving, and now Ward threw a punch in there. Now the teams have to be separated. There was pushing, and then Ward just came over the top and threw a left hand. Terry Holland and Craig Littlepage, both head coaches, are on the court talking to referee Tommy Lopes.
Mayhem underneath. Lots of contact. Let's watch 12. Ward. No need for that. Cheap shot. Ward slipped in and hit a guy in the back of the head. I'm not sure if the officials saw that, but if they did, they ought to take him out of there.
Well, that's what is exactly happening. Ward has been ejected from the game.
I love aggressive players, but that, no need for that. I mean, yeah, it wasn't even a play. Just walked up and slapped him in the back of the head.
It was
unfortunate.
It was slowly building. He was getting more and more aggressive. Certainly don't want to see something like this happen when you have two guys that worked with each other for so long, as Littlepage and Holland did. They're not happy about this.
Nah, they're under control. There's no malice there in terms of between the teams or the coaches. That's very unfortunate. Well, let's see who this fires up. Virginia has been on a tear. Let's see if this little cessation in activities cools them off. A flagrant.
So Mel Kennedy will go to the free throw line for Virginia. He will shoot two shots. Melvin Kennedy in the game.
Rutgers with three players already out. Zucker, Duckett, Campbell now losing Ward early on. They just don't have enough depth to justify that kind of careless action.
Mel Kennedy 1-for-2 from the line. And now Virginia will get possession at midcourt. So the Cavaliers lead it by 9 points and a minute 42 left in the first half of play. Emery Ward has been ejected from the game. He left with no points. Terry Holland still has the ear of Tommy Lopes on the far side of the court. And that's what the delay is all about. And there's a look at Emery Ward.
Well, Terry Holland, very cool and collected. But there is considerable discussion.
Rutgers has had scoring droughts in this first half of 4-11, and then later 3:58, which is happening right now.
Well, Dattica, who was such a force on Saturday, really hasn't gotten into it offensively. Riggins got the big start, and when he was in there, they had an offense. Otherwise, they've struggled.
I don't know what Holland is talking about, but I think he thinks that there should be technical foul shots taken and then the foul which occurred in the middle of the lane. Now, is there a technical foul if a player is ejected, or is he just ejected cleanly?
Well, it was a flagrant foul, which is an ejection and a two-shot foul, which we saw. Evidently, there wasn't a foul on the play, and I frankly don't remember. I know it was a heck of a hassle, but I don't remember a foul on the play.
So Virginia gets possession of the ball. Things are ironed out. Now from the side, the jump shot taken by Sims, and the rebound pulled down by Dixon. Here's Dattica. Rutgers needs a bucket in a hurry to get back in this game.
They've got to be careful here. a couple of mistakes and, you know, they could go down like 13 or 14. Perry telegraphing that pass in the backcourt. He looks very uncomfortable out there on the perimeter, trying to feed Riggins.
He back in the game along with Richard Morgan. Apparently what happened was the flagrant foul should have been the two-shot foul. Then there also should have been the one-and-one, which the officials seem to have forgotten about.
Could be.
And that's what Terry Holland was.
They surely had
about.
Stopped play. The whistle had blown when Ward hit Kennedy in the back of the head.
Whistle call, blocking foul. It's on Batts away from the ball. And so Rutgers, with 54 seconds left in the first half, will get another chance.
Batts setting a moving screen, trying to help a little too much as his teammate cut off. That's the responsibility of the player being screened for, to rub his man into that screen.
That's only the second team foul on Virginia in the first half. That's amazing.
On the road, you bet it is.
Gattaca for three. Rebound, John Johnson. He penetrates and leads it in.
Again, Rutgers back with enough manpower, but nobody taking the initiative to really put the stop on the penetration. Johnson's tough. He keeps that dribble alive. You have to seal him off, make him pick it up. Easier said than done.
Virginia has scored 12 points in a row. 15 seconds left in the first half. And a pretty dunk by Peterson, and he drops the foul.
Good pass by Gattaca. Mark Peterson coming all 245 pounds of him down the baseline. Had a big night against Princeton. 20 points, 10 Reeves, a red shirt 2 years ago.
Riggins to the bench. 12 points in the first half for Riggins. One personal foul. Steve Brown reporting for Rutgers, replacing Gattaca. Gattaca with two fouls and no points. That's significant, isn't it?
Very definitely. He's got to come alive in the second half.
Peterson converts on the three-point play, and Rutgers is within eight. 12 seconds to go. First half. Down to six. Morgan. Johnson. Kennedy. And it will not count. And that is it for half number one. Cavaliers of Virginia lead it by a score of 30 to 22. With same group that started the game, Riggins, Perry, Peterson, Gattaca, and Dixon. The backcourt of Gattaca and Dixon, goose eggs. Big story in half number one. Dixon penetrates. And the rebound pulled down by Mel Kennedy. High score for Virginia that first half of play, Andrew Kennedy with nine. And the rebound to Eric Riggins. Richard Morgan had eight for the Cavaliers. After the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers, as I mentioned, Riggins had 12, not 10. Gattaca getting his first points of the game.
That's key. Gattaca, big offensive show. 4-for-7 from the three-point area on Saturday. Only 0-for-1 from the two-point area. But definitely, if Riggins is going to operate inside, there has to be a little leverage with some outside threat. Gattaca has to produce that.
Johnson, he hits. John Johnson. And a little point guard now with 6 points in the game.
Way ahead of schedule. Saturday he only had six all day. But again, those 12 big assists were impressive.
Gattaca with it to Rutgers, pushing away from the ball. Riggins and Andrew Kennedy. And Andrew Kennedy is ticketed with the personal foul.
Followed by Andrew Kennedy. His first personal foul.
He's been playing very aggressive defense to only have one foul.
Rutgers with the basketball, trailing by eight. If Gattaca and Dixon could get more involved in the offense in the second half. Riggins with an air ball. Loose ball taken away by Morgan, who really wants it. Here's Morgan to Johnson. Johnson pulls up. Rebound, Perry. And a foul is called on Virginia on the follow.
Mel Kennedy, too, grabbed that rim. Could nearly have been a technical foul.
His second personal foul.
Terry Holland shouting instructions defensively. Virginia in an aggressive man-for-man, but the key matchup is Andrew Kennedy and Eric Riggins. Riggins now moving outside.
Hook by Curry is short. Mel Kennedy with the rebound. Here's Johnson in transition. Kennedy, he hits. Andrew Kennedy, 11 points.
Kingston, Jamaica, by a junior college in Texas. A circuitous route to Charlottesville, but a good one for the Cavaliers.
Scarlet Knights try to get something going offensively. Rutgers currently 0-3 in the Atlantic 10 Conference. Gattaca pulls up. Nice blast jump.
Boy, he shows those flashes of how he averaged 33 points a game as a high school senior.
Johnson, all the way.
Boy, his eyes light up when you give him that soft pressure. He likes those spaces.
The other night, all he was doing was laying them off, whereas tonight, he's laying them up and in.
Well, it's pretty tough to go all the way against St. John's.
Out of bounds, and will still be Rutgers ball. Funny comment by John Johnson. He said 150 people came to see the game because he is a Bronx product. He said after the game, he saw his cousins, his friends, and lots of other people that he didn't even recognize that came up to him and thought he was the, tried to act like they were family.
Perry buried out of bounds, couldn't find an outlet. Virginia, aggressive man for man, looking good.
Here's Johnson. Morgan. Oh, Morgan's really feeling it. And he is heating up. Head points for Morgan, his season high, 15 against Temple. 12-point Virginia lead, 16:35 second half. Riggins. And a foul called. And it's going to be on Virginia for blocking out Perry on the other side.
Mel Kennedy really working to get on that offensive board.
Third foul on Mel Kennedy. So Virginia's picked up three team fouls. They only had three in the whole first half. And here's Dixon with the jumper. He's on the scoreboard. So there is life in the Rutgers backcourt as Dattica and Dixon have scored here in the second half.
The Rutgers call is by Miles Dixon.
Jackson penetrates. Dishes off to Melvin Kennedy, who blew the easy one. Dixon on the break. Takes it, swiped away by Morgan. Rutgers ball. Substitution for the Cavaliers as Mark Cook comes into the game. 6'4 freshman, Martinsville, Virginia. And out goes Mel Kennedy with three fouls.
Well, that's part of the payoff. That's a downside of that aggressive man for man. Virginia will claw you a little bit. They'll get in foul trouble. They feel like they have nine players.
He's played 11 tonight. He only played eight in the semifinal game.
Well, they're starting conference play next week with Duke. Actually, it's this week on Saturday.
Side jump, Kennedy. Foul called underneath. And it's on Rutgers, so each team blocking out is getting called for fouls. At least they're consistent. 38-28, Virginia, second half.
No team in the National Football League has better, more knowledgeable fans than the New York Giants. And Giants fans will not want to miss the next Prestone Giants Journal. Madison Square Garden Network takes you behind the closed-door meetings and practices of the New York Giants. Sam Rosen reviews last week's contest and looks forward to the Giants' upcoming battles each Saturday evening at 6:30. For entertaining features and interviews, tune to Madison Square Garden Network for the Prestone Giants Journal.
Have you ever heard a hockey game?
Gretzky shoots. Score!
There's so much to hear, but Rory has never clearly heard the puck drop or his dad's voice. He's deaf. A hearing aid can help, but the real answer lies in research. The Deafness Research Foundation is trying to find cures for the 16 million hearing impaired. Won't you help?
Support the Deafness Research Foundation. There's so much to hear.
Virginia in motion. Johnson over the top to Sheehy. Back to Johnson. Nice little move under control. Dadica just punched his ticket. Morgan, a superb athlete who never could get it on track on Saturday, is showing what he can do here in the third place game.
So it's really been three guys carrying the scoring load for Virginia. 11 points for Andrew Kennedy, 10 for Morgan, and 8 for Johnson. 38-28 in favor of the Cavaliers. Mark Cook, number 31 in the game for Virginia. Johnson, Morgan, Sheehy, and Andrew Kennedy. Johnson dumps it on the baseline to Cook. Rebound to Miles Dixon. Rutgers running a little bit here in the second half. Dadica, pretty feed to Peterson, and he just couldn't control it, and he's called for traveling.
Peterson really hustling, though, trucking baseline to baseline. Terry Holland scratching his head on that one. Rutgers able to make the pass right to the box. Mark Peterson really, really moving it. You know, those big men have to run about 30 feet further from baseline to baseline. The guards just go free throw line to free throw line.
Johnson bounces it inside to Kennedy, and he lays it up and in. What a front job he did there.
Well, there's no question. Virginia's the better team. They're stronger, more experienced. Rutgers manages to stay within striking distance. The key right there, Dadica. He's got to open it up from outside.
40-28, Virginia. 14:30 to go in the second half of play. Dixon to Riggins. Riggins takes the baseline, pulls up. Pretty move.
Putting it on the floor, much better. Has not been very effective when he's had the dribble. He's greatly improved that part of his game.
Side jump perfect by Mark Cook. First basket for Cook.
Martinsville, Virginia. Turned out some fine players there.
Dixon penetrates. Riggins lost control that time. Turnover, number 14 for Rutgers. Virginia only has 7. Back in the game for Rutgers, Steve Watson. Bucky begins talking about the movement of Riggins to the hoop. Next time, he carries it out of bounds.
Well,
failed, Coach.
He's got to be assertive. This Rutgers club desperately needs him to be very assertive.
Morgan, he hits. Morgan with 12 points. He shot just 2 for 11 against St. John's. He has come back in impressive fashion today. 6 for 10 for Morgan. Nice feed to Perry, but a foul is called on Mark Cook. The dish off came from Miles Dixon.
Boy, Cook with a very, very assertive foul. Good diagonal pass. Perry wide open underneath. With authority, that foul was committed. The back of that defense fell asleep, but it was a superb pass.
Lee Perry at the free throw line. He is the younger brother of Tim Perry of Temple University, who is one of the outstanding shot blockers and rebounders in the nation.
Well, that free throw is very flat.
Perry, a freshman from Freehold Borough High School in Freehold, New Jersey. And we have a whistle. Is that a lane violation? And it will be Virginia ball.
Must have been. It wasn't 10 seconds. A phantom call.
Wasn't a Globetrotter fake, was it? Virginia by 14, 13:15 to go. Andrew Kennedy looking inside, has nothing. Out of bounds off of Riggins, who is much more active here in the second half. Madison with the basketball.
Rutgers occasionally doing some trapping when that ball goes in the corner.
Sheehy, that's where he likes it, in the paint. 2 points for Tom Sheehy, six in the game. Cavaliers now by 16, and that is the biggest margin in the ball game. Dattica with the pump fake. Watson for three. Rebound to Little Johnson. Here he comes. All the way. Rebound Riggins. That one would have been for the highlight films if it would have dropped.
We noticed the officials tonight, the usual attempt for 3 points was the arm out to the side. Spoke with Ed Stites, who will be our guest between games. Will be Dave Sims' guest, explaining tonight they're doing some experimenting, and the signal indicating that it is a three-point attempt is one hand over the head with the three fingers extended, and then if it's good, the football field goal signal. So we're seeing history being made here in an experimental way.
Dixon fouled as he made the move. Little Page said of Dixon that he showed the type of ability that he has in the loss to Georgia Tech. And here tonight in the first half, Dixon had 7 assists, although he did not score. Hoping for a lot of good things from Miles Dixon, who was overshadowed in high school by David Rivers and by Kenny Wilson at St. Anthony's, the well-respected St. Anthony's High School in Jersey City, New Jersey. Dixon dumps it off to Watson. It throws up an air ball, and here come the Cavaliers. Morgan leads to Sheehy. Almost put it up and in. Rutgers back the other way. Dattica. Got it.
Watson has to learn that when he throws up an air ball, the best thing he can do is get back. He was very fortunate. Sheehy ran out of real estate down there, or his air ball would have been compounded by a layup at the other end.
So Rutgers trails by 14. Cook losing possession of the ball, and it will be Rutgers' ball on the turnover. So Rutgers down 14, but they're still in it. 11 minutes, 36 seconds to go in the second half. As you look at Morgan trying that long lead to see.
I'm spending a day discovering the outer limits of Mazda's new RX-7 Turbo with one of Mazda's racers, Rod Millen.
Now, I don't recommend you run this Eddie-cooled turbo up to 140 miles an hour.
Or go 0 to 60 in 6.7 seconds, or take it up to its 0.86G cornering limit.
You really ought to go take a ride in one, but not with this guy.
Motor Trend Magazine's Import Car of the Year, Mazda RX-7.
Brand new and newly rebuilt Jack LaLanne's are underway from Long Island to New Jersey. Thousands of square feet of facilities designed to make the most of every inch of your body. You'll get full use of all the latest exercise equipment, our co-ed exercise floors, Olympic-style pools, and more. Come to Jack LaLanne Health Clubs today. We have big plans for your body.
Bruce Beck, Bucky Waters back at the world's most famous arena, Madison Square Garden, Virginia leading Rutgers 46-32. And Bucky, as far as points in the paint are concerned, Virginia has scored 10 buckets in the paint, Rutgers only 2.
And as they say, therein hangs the tale. Down the court again now, pressure by Virginia.
Riggins off it goes to Steve Watson. And a reaching foul called on Sheehy. Number one.
Followed by Tom Sheehy.
But the foul situation could be significant because Virginia had 16 fouls. Rutgers only one with 11 minutes and change to play. Quite a turnaround from the first half of play. The Cavaliers in the first half committed only 3 personal fouls. So Rutgers looking at 1-1 on the next foul by the Cavaliers.
Steve Watson, number 31, the 6'9 freshman, spends most of his time out on the perimeter.
And I believe we have a foul or a technical foul.
Technical.
A technical foul has been charged against the Rutgers coach.
It's on Craig Littlepage, who was complaining that when Watson went through, he was being held by Sheehy.
Well, just by maybe three, four fingers. It wasn't two hands full. Now this will be two on the bench.
Sheehy hits the first, 86% free throw shooter.
Tom Crowley is assistant. Another pen man, fine player there.
Sheehy one for two. And now Virginia gets the ball. That's where it really means something to get possession. When you don't have it, get the free throws,
right,
then you get it back.
That's when you know that the technical was not done with any sort of design when you lose possession.
Andrew Kennedy. Tipped up and in by Sheehy. It will not count. The ball was in the cylinder. And it's offensive interference.
Only a little piece of it has to be in there. This is not a great angle to judge that, but it did appear to us that part of the ball was in the cylinder extended. Good call.
47-32 Virginia. Gattaca with it. Miles Dixon. Watson. Here's Riggins. That's where he likes it. Down low. Tipped out of bounds, and it will be Virginia basketball.
Watson, nice pass inside. Just a little quick deflection. Still hard for me to see him at 6'9 out there on the perimeter as much.
Little half, Lance Planks.
Half soft, half court trap now.
Sheehy with it. Puts it up and in.
Doesn't really matter. Virginia able to penetrate almost everything defensively. Craig Littlepay just put up there.
49-32 in favor of the Cavaliers as they begin to open up very quietly. Watson, three-pointer. He finally gets one. So Steve Watson is on the scoreboard. He was 0 for 5 against Georgia Tech. That's his first points of the game, and Rutgers is within 14 all of a sudden.
Yeah, but against Georgia Tech, he had 6 assists and only 3 turnovers, which is impressive for the 6'9 freshman.
Held ball, arrow points in Virginia's favor. They will keep possession. Terry Holland getting a lot of people into the act tonight. Derek Sims and John Johnson check back in. Is that again looking ahead to what will unfold in 87?
They only played 8 players on Saturday afternoon, but as you know, this is a game for third place, and the next one is Duke in starting conference play. If you don't get them in tonight, you're not getting them in.
John Johnson gets the bucket. He has 10, and Virginia leads by 16. We asked Terry Holland about Duke. Are they good? He looked back and said, yeah, they're good. Riggins, who's glass of it? 16 for the Rutgers senior from Patterson, New Jersey.
University of Virginia only had 6 points off its bench against St. John's. Richard Morgan again, 2 for 11. That was crucial. They took him out of a starting rotation, brought him off the bench, and he just didn't deliver.
Foul ball, Watson holding Kennedy. That's quite an assignment for the freshman. Mel Kennedy back in, replacing Cook. Mel Kennedy was a little bit upset. A lot of the papers said that he was held in check by Brust, and he says, Willie Glass was the guy that kept me quiet in the second half, not Brust.
Willie has his work cut out for him tonight because Georgia Tech has a fine pair of forwards. Willie's been up and down offensively, but defensively, he normally is very steady, very good. He'll be tested tonight.
Foul is on Mel Kennedy, his 4th. And Sheehy back in, replacing Mel Kennedy. Now, Virginia is over the limit. And if Rutgers is going to make a run with 9:07 to go, I would think their plan of attack, Bucky, is to go inside to Riggins and try to draw some fouls and feast on the line.
Indeed, and that man right there is capable of going to three-point range as well and opening things up.
But it doesn't matter if you convert like that from the free throw line, and that's what Rutgers did the other night. They struggled from the foul line. What a turnaround as John Johnson goes coast to coast, gets the hoop, chance for a three-point play.
What's amazing there is he has the great acceleration. He's got the dribble. Now watch as he gets into the paint. He stops his forward motion and goes straight up. That requires great agility. It also negates the charge and that forced pass when your momentum is into the pass and it's too hard to handle. Very, very impressive. 6-foot junior from Brooklyn.
13 points for Johnson. You like him?
Yeah, for this club, I like him. He's a little small. He's going to present problems for him defensively because of that size in the Atlantic Coast Conference, but he's a good offensive player.
Rutgers down by 17, Dixon. Out of bounds, Riggins was there, but he just couldn't get control of the ball. Now Steve Brown comes in, replacing Dixon.
Steve Brown is not a great outside shooter either. I think they've got to go to Datica for the outside shot. And Riggins inside. They've got 8 minutes and 30 seconds. 17 down. They got to start now.
Rutgers into a flat zone. Sheehy lead to the middle to Dislin. Johnson fires. He hits.
Talking about size of guards in the Atlantic Coast Conference, there's one guy he can post, Tyrone Bogues, a 5'3" guard from Wake Forest who really can't play.
Johnson 5 for 7 in the second half, shooting-wise, 15 points in the game. Datica comes back, 3-point field goal for Rutgers.
That's good, the crowd's up there. It's it almost looks like a mural here, they're so quiet. Looks like they're painted in the seats. Neither team able to get anything going and get this crowd into the game. Very lackluster third place game.
Foul ball away from the ball.
Followed by Steve Watson.
And it's on Steve Watson of Rutgers. Virginia leads it 56-40. I grew up not far from Madison Square Garden. And I've been a Knicks and Rangers fan as long as I can remember. My heroes were Frazier and Monroe, Jacquemin and Gilbert, and oh yes, a gentleman named Marv Albert. There's a rich tradition and history to this building, and I try to convey that every time I cover a Knicks and Rangers game, a college basketball contest, or a boxing match at the world's most famous arena.
Bruce Beck brings the Garden home on Madison Square Garden Network.
Big wins are won with the heart. Big wins are won with the heart.
Find out about sports for people with disabilities. Call your Easter Seal Society.
Big wins are always won with the heart.
Our guests between games. One of our guests, Dr. Ed Stites, who will talk about the controversial 3-point field goal.
Not so controversial.
Not when you make it like that, as Datica
drills it from outdoors. Here's Watson, Walker at 6'9. I'm sorry, not Steve Watson, the 6'9 freshman, also showing that you don't have to be a 6-foot guard to be a 3-point player. Nice looking stroke.
This program is authorized by Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated solely for the entertainment of our audience, and any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event, including the imposition of a charge for viewing the program without the express written consent of Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated, is prohibited. Virginia with the ball. Virginia with a 16-point lead. 7:41 to play. Third place game. E.C.A.C. Holiday Festival. This the 35th edition. Terry Holland's getting a lot of people in the game. 16 points off the bench from Virginia. They had only 6 against St. John's. Quite an improvement there. Watson dumps it off to Perry. That will still be Rutgers ball.
Perry having a hard time. He's getting some good passes in there. He's just having a difficult time getting squared up and in a position to make a move to the basket. That's experience.
Watson. Here's Brown. He pulls up. Rebound, Riggins. Got it in the foul. Goal 18 for Eric Riggins.
Brown takes the jumper from the top of the key, gets iron front, back front. Oh, a little push off there. You see double zero. Give him a little on the hip, get on that offensive board. I don't think it's going to make any difference. Rutgers just doesn't have that spark. You know, they had one good offensive half. They shot 63% against Seton Hall and were down 9 because Seton Hall shot 72. But this young Rutgers club needs to develop some ego offensively. They're just not a potent team offensively.
Foul called inside. You talked about that Seton Hall game. James Major of Seton Hall that night was 14 of 15 from the field for P.J. Carlesimo's troops.
I can't imagine shooting 63% at the half being down 9 when your opponent's shooting 72. This team has come from behind, though. They were down 19, Rutgers, to Princeton. And then they got it down to 2 points with 32 seconds to go. They let it get away.
Riggins, 1-1. Foul was on Andrew Kennedy, his second. Rutgers within 13, 7-1 to play. Rutgers still has only committed 14 fouls. Virginia, as you know, well over the limit.
Actually, in both Rutgers wins this year, they were a double-digit deficit, so they kind of like to get corners and fight their way out.
Hey, Bucky, things don't get much easier for Rutgers as you look at Miles Dixon getting back in. Upcoming January 3rd at Louisville, and then January 10th, Temple home.
I don't think I'd want to be going into Louisville right now, and that their game, the Rutgers game, will be the next game following the Kentucky Massacre. I mean, they took the defending champions and dismembered them in Freedom Hall, their court. 30 and change. So they're not going to be in a very good mood, even though they will have a week to cool off.
Fouls on Brown, his third personal. Rutgers now with 5 team fouls. Morgan will inbound for the Cavaliers. Virginia was 19 and 11 last year. Lost to DePaul in the NCAA tournament, first round. Finished tied for fourth in the ACC. They were 7-7. Here's Morgan. Beautiful.
Well, the book on him is he is exciting. Just never got on track on Saturday.
Watson to Brown. Dixon dumps it inside to Perry. Brown for three. Sheehy is there for the rebound.
Virginia coming out of the aggressive man-for-man now because of their foul problems, going straight 2-3 zone.
Sims from the side, and he connects. So Derek Sims is on the scoreboard. Junior from Alexandria, Virginia. Cavaliers lead it by 16 points. First ever meeting between these two teams. They've met 5 times on the football field, but never on the hoop court. Gattaca back in for Rutgers. 6 guys in the court. Finally, Craig Littlepage takes Lee Perry out of there.
Notice this, even though there's a 6-game losing streak, Littlepage, very, very fatherly. He's not jumping up and down and ripping people. Seems to be very patient with his team, and that's difficult to do when nothing's going right.
Gattaca looking inside, back to Watson. Here's Riggins. He likes it. Yes, and a foul. That is an NBA continuation call.
Again, Steve Watson making the entry pass with a little ball fake. His size at 6'9", a definite advantage up there. Throwing it right over the top of the short arrow, over top of Johnson, actually. A 6-footer feeding Riggins down inside. Now he needs to develop a little threat on that outside shot. He'll really be problems for the defense. Right now, I have to back off of Watson because he's looking to pass first.
Tom Everson, number 25, is in for Rutgers. Riggins at the line. He has 22 points. He is 20th in the all-time Rutgers scoring list behind John Somogyi, who can really put him up and in. 13-point game, 5:30 to go.
Somogyi never saw a shot he didn't like.
Sims dumps it into Kennedy, and foul is called. No basket. Foul number 4 on Eric Riggins.
Since Virginia has gone to the zone, they've really cut down on their fouling. Rutgers now catching up. They're at 6. Next one will be in the bonus.
Rutgers with 3 players currently in the pros. James Bailey, who had a career-high 35 the other night for the New Jersey Nets. Roy Hinson averaging 14 points per game, and he's 3rd in the NBA in blocks for the Sixers. And John Battle playing for the awesome Atlanta Hawks.
Mike Fratello, area. Metropolitan New York area coach, doing a superb job. Coach of the year last year in the NBA. Bud Webb, another exciting little guy, out for about a month. Talked about Tyrone Bogues earlier. You look around the NBA and college basketball, there is room for the talented little man. But you really do need to be talented.
Virginia leads it 61-47. Foul called in the backcourt as Danica tried to bring it up. It's on Morgan. Danica will shoot 1-1. That's the first personal on Morgan.
And Holland is hot. He is hot. That's the way Morgan played on Saturday. Not thinking. Irresponsible. The one thing Virginia doesn't need right now is fouling and stopping the clock. Terry Holland might also think about coming out of the press.
Danica, a sophomore, he led the New Jersey public schools in scoring as a high school senior, averaging 34 per game, and we've seen flashes of brilliance over the Holiday Festival, but other times when he just can't get it on track. Coming up next, St. John's and Georgia Tech for the E.C.A.C. Holiday Festival Championship.
Morgan posting up on Dattica down underneath now that Rutgers has gone man.
Rutgers in transition. Dixon three on one. Hands off to Wiggins. Hold those glass and now has 25 points.
Dixon is fortunate he didn't get called for a charge there. He was out of control, went all the way to the baseline.
12-point game. Wiggins should make the all-tournament team. 51 right now in two games. Sims, Kennedy, rebound Wiggins. Rutgers can cut the lead to 10. And all that teaching, all that patience by Craig Littlepage might just pay off here.
He's never lost his cool.
Dixon cross court to Watson. Datka for three. He hits it. Rutgers in within nine.
And it was Craig Littlepage who called timeout.
So Rutgers coming back strong. They trail by nine with 3:59 to play.
This high-performance drink can help you get started every morning and help keep you going every day. STP gas treatment. Consumed regularly, it cleans your fuel system to help maintain the smooth movement of peak performance. STP gas treatment, the high performance drink for your car.
Hitting home runs is the fun part of my job. Catching is the tough part, the sweaty part. But you won't catch me showering with deodorant soap. I made a break from all that. A clean break with Ivory. Look, that's basic, natural, honest soap. Not like soaps that cover you with smelly perfumes or deodorants. What's that got to do with clean? Ivory's clean is an honest clean. You can smell it, you can feel it.
Make a clean break, because you just can't beat Ivory's honest clean.
Even when you got a special date.
Don't forget, coming up between games, it's Dial College Basketball. Dave Sims with Dr. Ed Stikes talking about the three-point shot. And our own Bucky Waters, 212-736-MSGN. We're looking forward to taking your calls between games.
Well, that's a real coup to be able to go right at Dr. Ed Stites. Now, here's Miles Dixon in transit, trying to go cold. Now, watch now. He doesn't stop. He continues his momentum down, but a good shovel pass off to Riggins for a deuce. Dixon has just got to get under control. He's got that blazing speed, but when you get to the broken circle, speed's no good anymore. You got to have both feet set so that you can see and react to the defense.
3:55 to play. Rutgers within nine all of a sudden. They were down by 19. They were on a 15-5 run to get back in it. But there's Mr. Morgan connecting again. 16 points for Morgan.
Boy, that's a tough shot, too. Driving in there, pulling up at 8 feet. High arc.
Watson looking inside. Perry turns, has it swiped away by Cheehy. Four on one fast break. Johnson takes it all the way, lays it in. Beautiful move by Johnson.
Perry again just having a tough time underneath. His teammates are finding him, getting the ball, but he's having a hard time turning it into something productive.
So Virginia answers with consecutive hoops after Rutgers had cut the lead to 9 points. Dixon goes cross court to Danica. Watson. Curry having a lot of trouble inside. Dixon working on Johnson. Backs him in, but he's called for traveling. Riggins back in for Rutgers, and they sorely missed him.
Tom Everson, just a cameo there. 6'10 freshman from Brentwood, New York, the home of Mitch Kupchak. Good player.
Sheehy with the ball, pulls up. And it's tipped up, no good by Kennedy. Finally pulled down underneath by Perry. 2:30 to go. Dixon. That was a good look on the part of Dixon, but it went through the hands of Riggins, and he taps Dixon on the behind, says, good look, I'll get it next time. My mistake.
Terry Holland just not happy with his team, feeling he should have put Rutgers away a long time ago. Looking at a 13-point lead with 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go, and neither team is going to want any part of this game in their highlight film. Not well played.
John Johnson backing in. Takes the baseline, puts it up. Tipped in by Sheehy. Called for an offensive goaltending earlier in that type of play. This time he gets the roll. No call, 11 points for Sheehy. Virginia by 15.
Rutgers anxious to get that ball and run with it. Forgetting to check off the defensive board.
Six straight for the Cavaliers, and they got the six straight when it counted. And the Rutgers have cut it to 9. Danica way off balance. Here comes Morgan. Johnson. And he's putting a little extra mustard on that try, and he's called for traveling.
He should have given it up earlier. Mel Kennedy was open.
That's Blanks back in for Virginia. And don't forget, coming up next, it's Georgia Tech against St. John's. That game will begin approximately 20 minutes after the completion of this game.
Bob Metcalf, number 4 in. Terry Holland trying to get everybody in now and give them a little Garden experience. Better be careful. Just 15 points, a minute and 30 seconds. I don't guess I can blow this one, but he surely has cleared his bench.
Here's Watson. He goes glass, rebound Melvin Kennedy. In the game, number 4, Rob Metcalf for the Cavaliers. That's his first appearance of the day. Sheehy backing it against Riggins. Foul ball, and Sheehy goes glass, got it in the foul. Sheehy.
Good slant pass into Sheehy, making a move on Riggins, not known for his defensive ability. Sheehy using his superior size and weight to get the good angle.
So Riggins fouls out and leaves with 25, 51 for the two games. And he played well in both contests, and he fouled out in both contests.
Well, he put two back-to-back, which has to be encouraging for Craig Littlepage. He's been really up and down from 2 points to 20 and back to nothing. Maybe he can get a streak going. But as we've already said, it's from here to Louisville, an angry Louisville coming off of a 30-point defeat to hated arch rival Kentucky. They are not going to be in a good mood.
Sheehy connects at the line. Sheehy leaves with 14. Andrew Kennedy has left with 14. And with a minute 9 to go, Virginia leads 70 to 52. By the way, John Johnson in the game finished with 17 points and 7 assists. So what a tournament he had, Bucky.
Really did. He came home and played well. Many times players coming home that way do not play well. They press and try too hard.
54 ticks on the clock. And Virginia leads at 70 to 54.
Well, I'm sorry. I've kind of left this one. I'm thinking about that championship game. Georgia Tech, St. John's. The Redmen trying to make it 2 in a row over the ACC, which will, in bars and other scholastic circles, will make for a great deal of evidence.
Well, tomorrow night, more basketball on MSG Network. The Knicks with 3 consecutive wins take on the Malones. Jeff and Moses at the Washington Bullets come to town. 7 p.m. Our pregame show. The Knicks have the Bullets tomorrow night as the Knicks look for 4 in a row.
Kevin Lockery, an old St. John's player.
So Virginia looking to improve to 6-2, and there's the red man anxiously getting ready. St. John's and Georgia Tech coming up next. Maybe early in the season, but it's interesting matchup, to say the least. Here's Rob Metcalf, a freshman from Port Edwards, Wisconsin. Did you ever recruit out there?
Nope.
Please be honest.
Should I have?
I don't know. Metcalf's the last guy in. Foul call on Mike Lettieri. Rutgers, the sophomore walk-on from Scott Plains, New Jersey.
I sure heck was in Brentwood because I tried very hard to recruit Mitch Kupchak.
28 seconds remaining. Anthony Solomon is at the line. He is a senior from Newport News, Virginia. Seldom used. Last year only averaged a point per game. This year he's under a point. He had to put his name in the box score. That's on the first.
Well, Virginia comes out of here with a split. There are two losses to Temple at home in the first game of the season, preseason NIT. And then again, losing to St. John's on Saturday in the first round of the E.C.A.C. Holiday Festival by 6. This is a dangerous Virginia team, fighting for the first division in the ACC, and that'll be tough.
Excuse me, Bucky. Alabalbo, the assistant coach at St. John's, described Virginia the other day like this. Patient, smart, play hard.
Yep. Terry Holland's teams do. You know, the only time he got a bad rap as a coach is when he had Ralph Sampson. And everybody thought they should have done more. But before and after the Sampson era, Terry Holland is one of the more respected coaches.
Rich Gattaca hitting inside, and again, Craig Littlepage calling timeouts, still teaching, still working with his team. The fans don't like it. But what is the coach going through? Can you share that with
him? Well, yeah, he just said, fellas, come on, 15 seconds and 16 points. Let's go. Let's get it over with. I think he really did respond to the crowd. I mean, it's one thing to teach, never say die, but I mean, if these guys are smart enough to be in a good school like Rutgers, they know that that is not attainable.
So a foul is called in the Lettieri with 14 seconds to go. Now we'll shoot 1-1 at the other end of the court.
It doesn't get easier for Craig Littlepage. Louisville, Temple ahead.
Solomon hits the free throw. 14 for Kennedy, 14 Sheehy, 16 Morgan, 17 for Johnson. The Kennedy is Andrew. For Rutgers, 25 for Riggins, 14 for Gattaca, but that was really it. Only two players were dangerous offensively in this game. Final seconds, 10 seconds to go. Virginia by 18. Lettieri. Rebound Virginia. Foul called on Rutgers with 4 seconds to go.
Oh, my. They must be getting paid on camera time or something.
Terry Holland doing a little chewing at Tom Corbin's ear. Bill Batts goes to the free throw line. An electrical engineering major at Virginia. Freshman from South Euclid, Ohio. Ever recruited South Euclid?
Nope. Should I have?
I don't know. 2 seconds to go, and that is it. Final score, Cavaliers of Virginia. Final score, 74, Scarlet Knights of Rutgers, 56.
About all you can say for that one is it's over. It's a win for Virginia. It's another loss for Rutgers. Neither team accomplished very much tonight. That's basically the story of games for third place. Now, I think we can look